Hello students, today we will start your section B actually from this main course book of unit 1. The story is 40 fortunes. Look at here, this is your main course book, and unit 1 of main course book. What was the name of unit 1? Is actually Laugh Out Loud. In this chapter we are reading some humorous stories. Today we will read the section B of this unit, and the name of the story is 40 Fortune. Let's discuss the title first, student. 40, you understand what is 40, and fortunes are actually your luck. Fortunes, the luck, destiny. So, actually in this story, we would see this is the funny title, not a funny video, and an odd title actually. 40 fortunes, how can we count the fortunes? That is what the thing that we need to discuss actually. But 40 for fortunes in Hindi means to say that 40 bhag, it looks very odd, but that's a fact. This is a student actually a play, and we have to discuss that. First we will have to discuss the characters of the play. First let's warm up a bit before we start. We have to discuss on some questions. Do you think the future can be predicted? Some people think it can be done. In many films also you have seen that on this topic the films are made, actually on the prediction of future. So what your opinion, student, that you have to share, what do you think about that? Do you think that the future can be predicted? And if it can be, then whether it is right or a wrong thing, that's what it's needed. So we will only in class can discuss that. What do you think about that? But what I personally think that predicting, what you have to predict, that's the thing. What would happen with you and what would not happen with you, in scientifically, if you want to know the answer, we cannot predict. But sometimes many things happen that we cannot explain scientifically. So but actually there are many people, some people who thinks that it can be done, and if the future can be predicted, then what do you think? It is a good thing to be able to know the future. Discuss with your partner. As far as I concern, I don't think so. It's a good thing to know the future, because if you will know the future, you will unnecessarily worry for many things, and you will try to do the things which would not necessary at the present. Nature has not given us to know the future for a cause, and if we do something which is not natural, and if we do unnatural things, it always create problem for us. So it's better not to know the future, because this is not natural, and doing anything unnatural is actually sin, and it's actually ultimately cause problem for us. So now, student, let's discuss the characters of the play. In this character, there are few characters. First is Ahmed. Ahmed is actually a servant, but in the story you would get to see that earlier. First he was the laborer, and then he became the servant. Jamal is actually the Ahmed's wife. And now here in her actually description, it is written chief of thieves, but in the story you would get to see that Jamal is actually the wife of Ahmed. It is actually students in an Iranian story, so and the names are of Iran, so that is why the names are not so familiar to us. Now, there is the king also in the story, and the king is actually, one second student, these are not the description of who the characters are. These are different characters, Ahmed it's someone else, Jamal is actually Ahmed's wife, and there is king also, and then there is minister's wife, another character, servant is someone else, Ahmad is not servant. You know, it is written in front of each other. It does not suggest that this is the description of Ahmad. Ahmad was not a servant. Servant is a different character. Ahmad is the different character. We are just seeing the name of the characters. Then there is chief of thieves in this story. You know, you just erase it. It is actually not. Jamil is not the wife. Is not the chief of thieves. And then there is a woman at the Vaat. You know, students, in this story, there is a Vaat place. And Vaat is the place, is a public Vaat place, where everyone of the area comes to take a Vaat. That is actually the Vaat place, you know, village Vaat place, where only women of the village comes to Vaat. That's what you will see in the story. And then there is narrator also in the story, who will narrate you the story. And actually, the most important person of any story is the narrator of the story. Now, as usual, the narrator actually starts the story for you. And what does the narrator would say? The narrator would say that once in the royal city of Isfahan in Iran, there lived a young man named Ahmad, who had a wife named Jamil. He knew no special craft or trade, but he had a soul, and as he often told his wife, you know, he wanted to narrate you further something also, but he will narrate you further in this story. First, let's see what the narrator is narrating you. Narrator is telling you that this is the story actually of a royal city. And where this royal city is? This royal city is actually in the Isfahan. Isfahan was the city, not now, not at present time. The name would have been changed. In the past time, it was actually in the Iran. You know, Iran is the country. And there, at this place, there lived a young man whose name was Ahmad, and he had a wife also. He was a married person, and who the name of whose wife is actually Jamil. And actually, Ahmad was a person who didn't know any special craft. A special craft here suggests you know, some magical powers. You know, in those days, people used to have so many superstitions, you know. They had blind faith, you know, and things like these. So, and you know, and he didn't used to do any trade. He was not a businessman. Trade is actually a student, your vyapar. So he was not a businessman. He was a laborer, and that is why he has a sawbill. And he just used to on daily basis, and actually somehow able to manage to run his livelihood. But actually, a student, you know, for you, it's no need to know the meaning of sawbill. Sawbill is actually a tool which looks like you know, a spade, you know, jisse hum log koi cheez uthate hain, aise balu gitti, aise sands, and just like that. Now, student, let's see what the Ahmad tells to her wife. You know, narrator is actually stops you where Ahmad tells something to his wife. He always says to her wife, his wife, that in a very cheerfully way, in a very cheerful way, that if you can dig a hole, you can always earn enough to stay alive. So with this, we get to know the profession of Ahmad. What does the Ahmad do? Ahmad is actually a person who dig holes where it is needed, where the landowners asks him to do so. He is a laborer, and he does what? He actually digs hole. वो गड्ढा खोदने का काम करता है, wherever the road is being built, or someone who is making a house, and if they need actually to dig a hole, so all in all those places actually he digs hole. That's what the Ahmad does. And that is why he tells to her wife that, you know, if you can dig a hole, you can earn enough every day. You can earn as much, so you can stay alive. For Ahmad, that's enough for life. You know, if you can earn as much as you can survive, that's more than enough for him. But that's not enough for everyone. that's the problem actually. Everyone is not satisfied, you know. People generally get greedy about materials, about money, about wealth, knowing the fact that these things are not the permanent things and they cannot give us the ultimate pleasure and peace. But still, that's the tendency of modern humans to run for materialistic things, which is totally a useless thing. The aim of life is actually, students, not to go after materialistic things. Actually, the aim of life is something different. That we will discuss in philosophical chapters. Right now, we should focus on the story. The narrator, now again, is telling you that was enough for Ahmad, but it was not enough for Jamil. As I was telling you, you know, Ahmad was actually satisfied with whatever he used to earn, but his wife was not like that. His wife was actually not satisfied and content with the life they were living. She wanted to live luxurious life like others. That's happened, it generally happens in our day-to-day life as well. So one day what happened, you know, Jamil went to the public bath. As I explained you here, in the village, in the city of Isfahan, there was actually a public bath where everyone of the city can go and have a bath. So actually one day Jamil also went there to have a bath. And but at the entrance, the woman in charge told her, actually at the entrance of the bath, where a woman who was guarding, who was in charge of the gate, who was the gate woman, is actually asked Jamil that you can't come in now. The wife of the king's royal diviner is taking the whole place for herself. So what does the actually woman in charge told to Jamil? The woman in charge actually told to Jamil that the wife of the king's royal diviner, you know, whose wife? The wife of king's royal diviner, you know, actually royal is actually the related to king, you know. Sahi diviner or diviner is someone, students, who actually tells you your fortunes, actually a fortune teller, you know, whatever is going to happen with you in the future. That's what a person tells you, a diviner. So he was the diviner of king of that place, of the Isfahan's king. He was the diviner in the court of king. So his value was very high, and that is why his wife is actually taking the whole place for herself. She said that while she is wearing, no one else would come here. She actually took charge of the whole place. So Jamil was obviously would not be very happy with this. So she was very angry. She got very angry, and she is saying, "Who did she think she is? Just because her husband tells fortunes, now it's saying that, oh, samajhti gaya apne aapko. Just because her husband tells fortune, what does she think of herself?" That's what the Jamil says, but to no avail, because the woman in charge didn't let her go inside. So she actually, Jamil returns home from there fuming. You know, fuming means, you know, very angrily. You know, she was in absolutely fighting, you know, furious with whatever happened there. So student, we have read the first page and the video is already long enough, about 15 minutes. So we should stop here. Tomorrow we will actually read from here what the Jamil comes home and what she tells to her husband.